गुड मॉर्निंग माही सिंह। बेटा ओपन योर कैमरा।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा, गुड मॉर्निंग। अपनीश ओपन योर कैमरा बेटा।
मैम वन मिनट, आई एम सर्चिंग बुक।
ओके ऑल ऑफ यू हैव योर बुक्स। Yes. Now, what did we do last week? Have we started this new chapter, a la cafeteria?
Ma'am, we have done the fourth question.
All right, we have done till fourth question also. Now, the next question is, Reponde. Reponde means reply. All of you know it by now. Now you have to reply. The first question is, Que mange Caroline? What do you mean by Que mange Caroline? Anybody can tell what it means?
Ma'am, what did Caroline eat?
Yes, it means what Caroline is eating. What is Caroline eating? So what is she eating? Beta, this question, all of you please open your cameras first of all.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning. This question you have to do in your copies. Take out your copies.
Which question?
On page number 25, question number 4. The fourth question, all of you have to do in your copies. Que mange Caroline? Now, what is this mange word? Mange comes from the word manger. Manger means to eat. Now, if we are talking about what Caroline eats, so Caroline is what? A girl, L. And how will manger be conjugated with L? It will be mange. That is why in question it is Que mange Caroline? What Caroline eats? So the answer goes, now tell me what she eats.
Fried.
Caroline mange. Yes, Caroline mange. They.
Excuse me, ma'am.
Yes.
Ma'am, can you send a PDF? I lost it.
You lost it. Beta, my PDF. Okay, I'll send it. Just a minute. I'm sending the PDF again on 8th A and 8th B group. Both the groups I have sent. All of you have done this one in your copies?
Yes, ma'am.
What is the next question? les enfants. Quand mange il bien? Now, how has manger word been conjugated with ILS by putting ENT in the end? That is why in the question it is written les enfants. That means we are talking about more than one third person, the children. When they eat nicely. When do they eat nicely? Tell.
Ma'am, it was the last third line.
Yes, the last third line. Il mange più volontiers à la maison. You have to write this complete line. Il mange più volontiers. Volontier means willingly. Più volontiers à la à la maison pendant le dîner. Okay, write it down.
Number 10.
All of you have done. Yes or no, beta?
Yes, ma'am.
Only one yes. No one else is replying in the class.
Ma'am, I'm doing the second one.
Okay, then let me know now.
Ma'am, done.
Okay, according to the second question, if I ask you, just wait, chill. Now, according to the second question, if I ask you, quand vous mangez bien, what do I mean? Let me write this question on the board. The question is, quand vous mangez Bien. I can give you this question in the exam. What do I mean
Ma'am, it means the same.
Yes, what it means, tell me.
Ma'am, when they eat nicely.
Why they? I have not put ILS.
Oh, kutte!
Ma'am, when we eat nicely.
Beta, what are you up to?
Ma'am, when you eat nicely.
Ma'am, when we eat nicely.
When you eat nicely. Okay, when you eat nicely. Now, how will you reply? What is your answer to this question? One meal in the day. There are times like in breakfast time or lunch time, you don't feel like eating much. In dinner, you don't feel like eating much. When is what is that meal when you eat nicely?
Afternoon.
Afternoon. So afternoon is what?
Lunch.
What is lunch called? We learnt it here only. We learnt it, isn't it? In the last chapter, it was in ER ending verbs. In the exercise, there was a verb. Déjeuner. Déjeuner means to lunch, right? To eat lunch. Now, what will be the answer of this question? Je mange bien. I eat well. During le déjeuner, or if you eat nicely during the dinner time, right? Le dîner. Okay, so these kind of questions, beta, you are going to get in your exams, the ones we have done in the chapter related to that and related to your choice. Okay, getting me?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
You can be questioned, like the previous chapter was about the body parts and all. So you can be questioned, what is the color of your eyes? Because you have learned colors, you have learned what eyes are called, right? What is the color of your hair? Then coming on to the next part of this chapter, is plural they know. Now, we make the nouns which, can I erase it? All of you have written?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now,
yes, ma'am.
English also, there are a few rules that we follow when we change a noun into plural. Like for example, the word is pot. How do we make it plural? By adding S, pots. The word is bus. How do we make it plural? By adding ES.
ES.
Buses. Yes?
Yes, ma'am.
Woman. How it becomes plural? Women. By adding E over here. This is the plural. In French also, there are a few rules that are to be followed while changing a noun into plural. Now, what is that first example? First example is the simplest of example by adding S. By adding S. Suppose the word is fee. What do we do? How do we make it plural? By adding S. The word is garçon. By adding S. Right? Everybody look up on page number 25. All we need to do is we need to change the article that is placed. La and une gets changed to les and they. Right? Isn't it?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Le and un also gets changed to les and they.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
then if suppose it is L apostrophe om, which means the man, what will it become? L apostrophe also changes to L-E-S. Liaison.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, what we have to take care of, we know how we have to change articles. Okay, we have changed the article simply. There is no rule apart from it to change the article. But when we change the article, now we have to take care of the noun, how the noun is to be changed into plural. Suppose my noun is F-E-U. How will it be changed? What it will become in plural? Tell me. Will become?
Ma'am,
they.
They. Nice. You.
Okay. F-E-U, and we will add X in the end to make it plural. All right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Now, there are a few nouns which remain the same in plural. Like, for example, the noun is ending in Z. A-ne. What we will do, we will only change the article to they. A gets
changed. Ma'am, we will not change it into plural.
Yes. Ne will remain ne. Why? Same. Because it is ending in Z. All the nouns that are ending in S, X, and Z do not change in plural. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Put a dot here, put a star, and write this point. All the nouns ending in S, X, and Z do not change in plural. Write it.
Okay.
And only nouns don't change. Articles always change. The article given before them will always be changed.
Now written.
All of you have written?
Yes, ma'am, written.
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Okay, next. Now, there are nouns that change. Okay, let me give you one more example. It is given in the book also. All of you have the book, right? Now, there is one more example. When any noun ends in E-U, A-U, or E-A-U, how it becomes? How it gets changed into plural? By adding X in the end. We have to add X. Like, for example, there are words like chapeau. Chapeau means a hat. Un chapeau, right? Now it becomes they
get.
And chapeau and
x.
Bateau. Bateau is a boat. It becomes the same. We add x in the end. But now see, there is an exception given in this block, yellow block, that the words, these two are what? They are exceptions. How? Even though they end in EU, but to change them into plural, we only add S in the end. To color blue, BLEU. Now, if you're talking about something in plural, we put blue into BLEUS. And what is the another word? No. It also remains the same. Those who do not have the book, beta, you can write it. Okay, next. Certain nouns ending with OU also take X in the plural. Now there are nouns. Let's just read them out. Un bijou, un calou, un genou, un chou, un ibou, un joujou, and un pou. Now they also take X in the end and become plural. But still, just under it, you have to write it. There are nouns ending in OU, but they take S in the end. Now, which are these two exceptions? Just keep these two exceptions in your mind. Which are those? A coup and a clue. Okay, what is clue? Clue is a nail. And who is neck? C-L-O-U, right?
Okay.
C-L-O-U is a nail. Our nails, nails on the fingers. And C-O-U is neck. A coup. Done?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Now see, there are a few words that end in A-L. Now A-L. So we will think that it's very simple. We will add S over there. In most of the cases, we add S. But there are a few words that get like the word is animal. Animal is also a French word. But if I have to change it into plural, if I say l'animal, that's singular. Now, how will I change it into plural? It becomes les animaux. Les animaux. I have to add O, sorry, UX in the end to make it plural.
Ma'am, means the words ending with L always change to be the expectation.
Not always, but this is an exception. There are words like the, it goes 50-50. There are words that get changed by adding AUX and some get only plural by adding S. But
so animal, how we will know?
We will learn it. We have to learn it. We will learn a lot many words through the book only, in this book only. Then signal becomes signo. Signo. Cheval. Cheval is a horse, which becomes chevaux. And our hair also. What is our hair called? Les chevaux. Then, what are exceptions to this? Un bal, un carnaval, un chacal, un ceremonial, un rethical. These are all exceptions. They become plural only by adding S in the end.
Okay.
Okay. Done, everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, next now. Coming on to the second group of verbs, which I already told you. Now, what are these second group of verbs? Like, we have finish, shuasir, grandir. Didn't I talk about it last week when we did the chapter?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, on page number 27, the pattern of these words is given. These IR ending verbs is given. Now, suppose the verb is finir. Let me explain it again. This is the whole verb. What is the radical here? Radical is that does not change. It is fini. What will change is IR. Now, IR becomes IS, IS, IT, ISSONS, ISSEZ, and ISSENT. This is the working of IR ending verbs.
Yes? And we did it in last class.
Yes, we did it in the last class. Because now I'm just revising it because the coming exercise is totally based on this verb. We are going to learn a lot many verbs today, which are based on this one. Okay? Now see, just go through all these verbs, other IR ending verbs, and write them in your copy. As it is, like shuazir means to choose. How you're going to write? Shuazir. To choose. What is the next verb given? Grandir. To grow. Like that. Write everything and then let me know. On page number 27, a green table is given. From there, you have to do this work. Start doing.
Now, what is the difference between second and third?
What is the difference between?
Second and third.
Okay. Grandir is to grow tall, to increase in size, while grossir is to become fat. Grossir comes from the word gross. Okay?
Okay.
I'm done.
All the verbs, beta, in both the tables that are given?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone has done?
In 1 minute. I'm done.
Okay. Now, coming on to the next part of this chapter. On page number 29, Sela Rontre. Manuel Ese Copa on Une Nouvelle Institutrice. Now, this one on this page. Everyone has this page? 29 page number?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. What you will do is you will just read it out and translate it and tell me. What is Bonjour les élèves?
Good morning, students.
Good morning, students. Then, je suis la nouvelle institutrice. What does that mean? Je suis. What is je suis?
I am. And it is okay, the name.
What about other students? Only Avnish is answering. What about you all, beta? Dhruv Pranjali, Dhruv Kumar, Mahi Singh, Mohammad Uzair.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, beta, where are your answers? I want all of you to answer.
Okay.
Yes. What is je suis la nouvelle institutrice? What does it mean?
Ma'am, I have the book of history.
No, what is nouvelle?
Ma'am, I am the...
Listen, nouvelle means new. What is nouvelle? N-O-U-V-E-L-L-E. I am the new instructor.
Ma'am, then good morning, madam. One boy said.
Yes, then bonjour, madame. And comment vous appelez-vous? What is comment vous appelez-vous?
Ma'am, what's your name?
Yes, what is your name? Then she says, je m'appelle Mariana, je suis espagnol.
Ma'am, my name is Mariana, and I am English.
Yes. No, not English. What is Espanol? Espanol is Spanish.
I'm Spanish.
Je suis Espanol. Now see, can you find one mistake over here? In this dialogue, what is the mistake? Tell me.
Ma'am, there is not apostrophe in external.
Any other mistake? Do you see any other mistake? There is no apostrophe in Espanol, but there should be an E in the end. Why? Because it is a female teacher, Mariana.
Yes, right? Ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
There should be okay. an E in the end.
And then she says that I will teach you math.
Yes. J'enseigne les math. I teach maths. Okay, done. Now the second dialogue, just try it yourself. Just try to read all the dialogues yourself and see if you can translate them or not. Done. The second one.
Ma'am, the meaning of this, ma'am, come the infants are with you. Ma'am, it means that you have children.
Okay. Combien d'enfants avez-vous? Yes. How many children do you have? Very good.
Good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, I have done and I have translated all.
You've done and translated also. Very nice. Any problem in any of the dialogues? Yes, any problem? Other children, I'm asking to you also.
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
What the 11th one?
Now we are going to meet the next week and then we are going to talk about it. We'll discuss it there. Okay, right now you can move for your next.
Bye, ma'am.
Bye, children.
Okay, ma'am. Bye, ma'am.
Morning.
Bye, ma'am.
Good morning.